A magnitude 5.3 quake rocked the Tinaga Island in Camarines Norte at past 1 this afternoon. It was also felt here in Metro Manila, with intensity 2 recorded in Quezon City. Stay with ANC as we bring you more updates on the quake. Moving on to more news, San Miguel has ended its power supply deal with Meralco. Meralco confirms that at 12 a.m. Wednesday, San Miguel Global Power's Ilijan plant stopped supplying it with 670 megawatts of electricity. This forces the utility giant to source power from the spot market, which tends to be more expensive. But Meralco says they are exhausting all efforts to try to shield customers from higher supply costs. San Miguel's withdrawal comes after Meralco failed to get regulatory approval to hike power rates despite the rise in global gas prices. Siding with San Miguel, the Court of Appeals recently granted a temporary restraining order that stopped its power deal with Meralco. President Marcos set to sign a joint administrative order outlining a timetable for establishing a farm-to-market road network. The order will set up guidelines to make all farm-to-market roads interconnected with other infrastructure projects to ensure efficiency in the delivery of services and enhance agricultural programs. Marcos earlier said the master plan would serve as a guide for government in promoting food security and empowering rural communities.
FMR ay approved na. Meron na tayong national timetable. Lahat ng agencies that are involved, departments that are involved should sign an MOU, will be signing an MOU by December, before the end of the year, para ma-approve na ang plano para sa pag-construct ng mga FMR.
After a red-hot inflation report, the Philippine economy sees some bright spots as the labor market continues to improve. Unemployment fell back to pre-pandemic levels at 4.5% in October from September's 5% reading. This translates to 2.24 million jobless Filipinos, down from 2.5 million the previous month. The underemployment rate, which indicates the number of people looking for additional jobs, also inched lower to 14.2% from 15.4%. The top industries with the largest increase in employment include transportation, manufacturing, and education. In contrast, industries with the largest drop in employed persons include agriculture, wholesale, and retail trade. Despite the high employment numbers, the National Economic and Development Authority recognizes the need to create more high-quality jobs. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says this should be prioritized if the country wants to pursue economic transformations. He also calls for stronger partnerships between the public and private sectors to expand skills development and opportunities in the country.